quite interesting, right? Let me show you how I did that. I'll walk you through creating this interesting fake 3D effect using AI tools like Midjourney, Runway, Topaz Video, and After Effects, with a few technical deep dives along the way. I started by generating a high impact image with Midjourney, a Mercedes G-Class SUV barreling through an autumn forest. I dialed in some specific tweaks and appended my personalized Midjourney code to the end of the prompt, which appears on the screen. The prompt goes like this. I am really happy with the result because it demonstrates how AI personalization can fine-tune aesthetics to match your own creative vision. Next, I switched to Runway, which has a nifty camera control feature that allows for generating smooth, frame-consistent motion from a single image source. This is key because having a same starting frame means that the transitions between clips remain seamless. In Runway, I generated directional moves left, right, up, and down, along with zoom in and zoom out effects. One thing to note here, when adjusting the movement sliders, be precise. For horizontal motion, I used a value of 1.5 for right movement, combined with a -1 pan rotation. Then for left, I simply inverted those values. The same principle applies also for vertical moves and zoom in and zoom out. Overextending these values can result in distorted outputs that are hard to fix later or actually unusable at all. So, while the individual clips capture linear motion accurately, they often feel too boring. To introduce a more natural flow, I exported the clips into After Effects for time remapping. But original output from Runway is not enough for that. You need way more frames so the motion do not get to skipping frames. And that's why I processed the footage through Topaz Video to generate 2x slow motion videos. This step not only increased the number of frames available for manipulation, but also gives more control when adjusting the timing in After Effects. Once I had sufficient frame data, of course upscaled to 4K resolution, I could move forward. Just a note to upscaling part, whether you choose to do it directly in Runway or within Topaz Video depends completely on your preference. It would work in both scenarios. These enhanced resolutions become especially important when you are integrating these clips into larger projects or mockups. Now let's talk about sequencing. I arranged the clips to start with a zoom in, followed by horizontal and vertical pans, and finished with a zoom out. Since every clip starts with the same base frame, reversing certain clips is actually essential to create a smooth, symmetric movement. For instance, for a full horizontal sweep, I took leftward move, then I time reversed leftward move and combined it with rightward move so I can get one long pan, and then reversed the rightward clip again to return to the original center frame. This approach not only maintains continuity, but also allows for creative transition that keep the viewer engaged. Important point here, just label your clips. As you start reversing and combining them, clear naming conventions save a lot of time and prevent mix-ups. Now, let's add some juice to the motion. When applying time remapping, use the graph editor to adjust speed curves. This way you can achieve easing in and out of movements, which translates to a more organic, less robotic feel. Experiment with frame interpolation settings to ensure that slowing down the footage doesn't introduce artifacts or jitter. And after you've perfected the sequence, the next step is to integrate it into a final composition. I typically place the clip on a mockup, say a modern website or app interface, and add sound effects that correspond with the key transitions. Subtle audio cues synchronized with the fast and slow segments can really elevate the impact of the final effect. For those looking to push the envelope a bit further, consider applying additional effects such as slight motion blur adjustments or color grading tweaks to match the project's overall aesthetics. These small refinements can do magic. And that wraps up the process by combining AI-generated imagery with advanced motion control, time remapping, and careful sequencing. You can create an engaging intro sequence that not only looks professional, but also tells the visual story through dynamic movement. Enjoy experimenting with these techniques, and if you would actually go for trying it, I would really like to see the result. But for now, take care and stay tuned for the next video.